Netflix Large Network's PAX coverage. We actually have played Boomerang Fu, which is a four-player local co-op multiplayer game where you destroy violently all sorts of types of foods.
And you play as
food. And you play as food in bloody fashion. Well, not very bloody, but it seems very violent. Some people because it is easily drunken couch fun where you reach the end of the level and there's always something happening and then you're on to the next sort of thing. Whereas Nidhogg changes like parts of the level as you reach the next screen. This was, as soon as everyone's dead, it's on to the next level.
So, yeah, first you get to
10 kills, I think. We're not 100% sure, but it looked like 10.
So, yeah, you play as individual food characters. I played as Mel. So when I got cured, like milk went everywhere. It was awesome. The avocado that was there. It fell out when he got killed. The donut was like kind of.
It was just cut out. It was pretty boring. Like, the avocado definitely.
Yeah, you had boomerang attacks. You could slash people.
And boomerang. Yeah. And then you mostly got around by jumping because you kind of walked like weird through. Like you're like, I'm a donut. I can't really walk. I can jump for some reason. So that's a thing. And then it would be all four characters just launching themselves across the different levels, throwing boomerangs. When you throw your boomerang, you can't spam it, then you have to go pick it up, and then slashing. And then there's a lot of, like, you jump over the top of each other, and the big person plays the perfect boomerang.
Yeah.
It was pretty fun, weird.
It was very cute.
It was very cute. Art style, we're like 99% sure, aren't we? That's done by, like, one of the people called
Adventure Powers,
like, same artwork. Yeah. You wanted the pin, which had the banana.
Oh, that's a cute little banana. Don't miss out.
So yeah, looks really cool. Boomerang Fu, keep your eye locked on that one. It said Steam, I think they said like, I think it said consoles future, hopefully. But it was like Steam, so. That was really cool. Stay tuned to ExposureNetwork.com for all our other PAX coverage, YouTube.com/ExposureNetwork, and find all the video stuff as well.